A rent strike has been set by Sussex Uni students living in the King's Road accommodation. The movement is rapidly growing in popularity as tenants join together to oppose the conditions they are expected to live and work in. They pay a high price for this seafront location. Mouldy carpets and walls are high on the agenda, with health concerns prompting the urgency.
I have asthma, and actually when I arrived here I was really surprised because of the conditions of the carpets. It looks like they never even clean it. It's like they have a lot of spots, but they are really disgusting. And I don't feel really, really good since I arrived here, actually.
And Rocio tells me her complaints do not appear to be recognized.
Like, I don't really feel like a support from university.
And the scaffolding that has encompassed the building and the advertised views has truly taken over their lives.
There's been renovation work that's been taking place here. And for them to do that, they require you to leave your room between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. every day. But sometimes they don't actually do anything in your room. So you spend the whole day outside of your room. It's especially problematic when you don't have any lectures to go to. And this time of year is not exactly warm or nice. I've been doing this for a week now, and I feel quite run down and tired. And I mean, it affects my studying. I mean, that's number one reason I'm here. And if I can't do that, then it's creating a really big problem for me.
So we've been kicked out from our rooms for like quite long days. Actually, it's our second time. Yeah, we can't even go back to our room. We've been missing one of the lights in the kitchen for past 2 months and a half. And so once when we claimed the porter about this thing, he came up and he replaced the light bulb. But then the next day, the light bulb was exploded on the table.
Wow.
Yeah, that I think it's really dangerous, because luckily there was no one there, but what if there was someone, you know, below the light bulbs? We had to wait 1 month more, then finally they fixed the electricity. Mm-hmm. But it took a long time, and during that 2 months and a half, our kitchen was really, really dark.
After Akane's description, Tom told us about more lighting issues in the building.
Probably the worst example from me on my floor is the builders left the skylights open overnight for like maybe 1 or 2 days, and it rained. So then it was just raining water onto our floor, and then that basically got onto the electrics, and we've subsequently not had lights on our floor for about a month now.
So, the educational body have allowed their students to live in dark, mouldy conditions, but these students were also expected to work without a vital tool, Wi-Fi.
We've been missing Wi-Fi constantly, and we've been claiming to the housing office or ID service or the head of campus residence. So like we did all we could do.
And the answer they gave, because they didn't even send us an email, like they didn't even say we are fixing it. Just like no Wi-Fi for 9 days. So yeah, I think that was one of the worst things.
And during our tour of the building, one student came out of his room to tell me that these conditions have played a role in him leaving his course and university.
I've withdrawn from my course for a number of reasons, but one of the things that just really stressed me out was things like the internet. I mean, that went off, and obviously students are highly reliant on that kind of, you know, access to do anything like assignments or just to keep up with like timetables or anything like that. But if it goes off for an entire week, what the system is, I think what the case is if the university doesn't fix it after a week, they're liable for compensation. But you think normally if this was on campus, they'd fix it in a couple of hours. But considering we're off campus, we're, you know, the less of a concern, it's more of a hassle for them to get down here and fix it. But if we lose the internet and we got assignments in, we can like have our grades like deducted in some way just because of that late submissions. So yeah, it was definitely a factor that just sort of drove me over the edge, I think. So
Callum from Acorn, an organisation dedicated to fighting housing issues in Brighton, says the university needs to do more to better represent its students. The current climate has the uni acting more like estate agents, he says.
So we know that when students arrive in the city, predatory landlords and letting agents are ready to rip them off, right? There are certain letting agencies which are notorious for just absolutely taking the mick with students. They're going to rip them off for all of their deposit, they're going to charge them huge fees, they're going to charge them exorbitant rents, and they know they can get away with it. What's really unfortunate is now the University of Sussex are proving that they too are a rip-off landlord. They too are willing to take the mick out of students. You know, really, these people, they have a duty of care to these students, right? The residents of King's Road are on their courses. They're in their university, they're in their university community, and at the moment, unfortunately, the university is acting like the worst landlords we see in the city.
Back inside, and the tenants believe this is a case of missing respect.
I mean, first of all, the housing people just need to show a tiny bit more respect. We just kind of get brushed away. I mean, I've been doing this since the beginning, about 2 months ago, October, and it's just, they kind of, the whole body language and everything, it's like, this isn't real, this isn't a problem, you're just students.
Sussex Uni are expected to act quick in this situation. If they don't, they will see the support behind the movement grow as quickly as a mouldy patch on one of their students' carpets. Matthew Enderby for Latest TV News.